there, everyone. My name is Miriam Delicado, and I'm here in Rachel, Nevada right now at the Little ALE Inn, as you can see, this iconic picture. I guess they probably had to do this over a few times over the years. I was out here in 1991 when there wasn't much out here, and it's definitely developed a little bit since then, but it's a wonderful drive to come out, and I really encourage you that if you're in the area, just to take the day to come out, look at the scenery, go into the Little ALE Inn, have something to eat, strike up some conversations, and you'll never know who you meet out here. So thanks for joining me. Check out the other YouTubes that I have for Miriam Delicado on my website. BlueStarProphecy.com is my website, and Little ALE Inn in Rachel, Nevada. Check us out. Take care.
Fantastic.
Good. It is a beautiful sunshiny day in downtown Rachel, Nevada.
It is, and I'm so excited to be here.
Good.
And I'm very grateful that you're giving us a couple of minutes of
your time.
That's
okay. I appreciate it.
So everyone, I'm here in Rachel, Nevada, and I came in late afternoon yesterday. Beautiful drive coming in from the north.
Of course.
But as it says on the website, please listen, there's cows on the road. Be very careful. It's really important.
Yeah, it
yes.
is. It very much is important to watch for the animals. And right now, we have antelope that are also migrating. And they can come up on you. They just blend in with the side of the road, and it can really be a scary thing.
Yes.
And but it's okay. They're beautiful to see.
And we're out in the middle of really nowhere.
We're the middle of everything. Everything goes on around us, miles around.
Yes. So, of course, the reason that Rachel, Nevada is so infamous is because, and I'll let Pat take over.
It's because we have an establishment here that you can come and sit and talk to people. Mm-hmm. You're not just eating here and you don't look at the people next to you. No, I encourage people to talk.
Yeah.
We've had two couples that was really awesome. They were both from New York City. Mm-hmm. And what they discovered while they were here is for 10 years, they lived directly across the street from each other.
Wow.
And they met here. So, you know, get to know your neighbors. Get to know what's going on in this world. It's fun
yes.
to have things go on like this.
Yes, and we're right beside the, you know, again,
Area 51.
Which makes Rachel famous because of the Little ALE Inn. So I was just talking to Pat, and just before we came on camera, saying that I came out here in 1991 after attending the second UFO Congress conference in Las Vegas.
Right, that's been a couple of days ago.
Just a couple
and
of days.
And I'm still here.
Yes, and Pat's still here. The Little ALE Inn is still here. The iconic aspects of it are certainly still alive and thriving.
Thank you. We appreciate everybody that comes out. We enjoy talking to people.
Uh-huh.
It's the one thing that I push is for people to talk to each other.
Yes.
Get off the computers, get off the phones. There's actual live people that come out here and you can talk to them.
Well, I came in last night and I just kind of sat and I just would look at someone and say, hello, how are you? And the next thing I knew, I was engaged in conversation. And with all the locals, I ended up talking to all the locals out here. And I will tell you, if you talk to the locals, you'll get some stories.
That's
so that's
true.
The way that, that's the opener. Just say hello, how are you? Tell them, I just arrived and it was wonderful.
You know, and it's fun to talk to people. It's fun to learn what other people know.
Yes.
And it those are important.
It's not all about UFOs either. It's about
life.
It's about life.
It's about all the cool things you get to see and do.
And
you go to an old mine. You can hike for miles. Mm. You can see beautiful cactus in bloom in certain times. So other than that, it's just a great place to be.
Yes.
And of course, at the Little Alien, we have very, very good food.
Yes,
all the time.
For and all the way from breakfast to dinner, and a lot of good desserts.
Yes, and they're open for quite a from 8 a.m. until 10 p.m.
We are now. During the summer, usually it starts the first part of April, very end of March. We will be. Otherwise, in October, we usually go from 8 to 8 every day, which is still a long day, and it's okay.
And so another thing that I wanted to just talk about for a moment, because I had some good conversations with everyone from the local area. And, you know, everyone that knows me knows that I've had some experiences and things myself. And, you know, I came out here very respectfully. And I think that it's really important that when people do come and visit, that they remember that there's people's lives here, and to be mindful and respectful of what's being asked of you. Not to really, you know, meddle in other people's lives that live out here and making up stories.
I think what you're saying is, you know, we have neighbors, and some of them have jobs that are security jobs.
Mm-hmm.
We don't talk about who they are, what they are. I'll never disclose any of it. And my employees are not allowed to do that, ever.
Right.
I mean, it's a pretty big thing if one of them says anything.
Yes.
We enjoy being able to talk to other people.
Yes.
But we also have to show the respect.
Right.
And it's fun to be here. Come and talk, come and enjoy what there is. So, and we have a great gift shop on top of that. And of course, you already know we have a good bar.
The bar is lovely. Sit at the bar, you can have a coffee, a tea, you can have alcohol.
Conversation.
It's fantastic. I want to make sure that I ask you about the events that you have here.
Well, the things that do go on, of course, we have a great Valentine's Day dinner. We have a really good Easter Sunday dinner. We have a free Thanksgiving dinner. It's a potluck, and we never do without anything. We have lots of things going on, so it's a good thing. Of course, we always have Halloween, you know. We have a motorcycle event, and it's quite a weekend. There is a marathon that runs in August on our highway. We have that. Of course, we have geocaching. We have world's largest power cache along our highway.
Wow.
And eventually we hope to make it bigger than it is.
Right.
Of course, it is the biggest in the world.
Wow. That's fantastic. So, if you come to Nevada, or you're even, you know, in the area, you're in Las Vegas or Reno or
wherever, just come and visit.
Come and visit. And so,
and you know, we can also get handmade quilts.
I didn't know that, see?
One of our neighbors make them. They're really awesome.
And so there's lots to see here.
And they have really cute aliens on them.
So come and check out Rachel Nevada. Come see Pat and the crew that's here.
It.
It's fantastic. It's fun. It is what you make it. And certainly, I mean, I've just been in constant conversations with people, and it's been a lot of fun. So thanks for listening. And thank you so much, Pat, for taking a couple minutes.
I hope we'll see you on another rebound trip.
I will.
All right.
Take care.
You.
Bye-bye.